with as we have gathered for Paris Air Show. So what is the current status of exchanges between India and Paris in terms of defense R&D?
Indo-French defense collaboration is dated back to late 90s. Formally, we have Indo-French forum for defense collaboration, and under that forum we also have an Indo-French R&D group. So we discuss R&D projects and various other programs under that forum. The meetings take place alternately between India and France, 1 year here, 1 year in Paris. Mm-hmm. I have also attended a couple of meetings. But in the last about 3 to 4 years, we have accelerated our program of Indo-French collaboration. You are aware of the fact that we started, at least I as a scientist in DRDO started my first project with Thales of France on development of a long-range, medium-range radar. And that radar was built between 2001 to 2005. It is operational today as part of my ballistic missile defense program. Today we are developing one more radar of the same type, but in India. So you can see that transition taking place. It was earlier built in Paris, and now similar radar we are building with Indian industry in India. So this is the type of collaboration we have developed. Second one now, which is emerging, is the collaboration with MBDA on our short-range surface to air missile. This is yet another under Indo-government collaboration. These two projects took place under the government-to-government collaboration. Besides this, there is interaction which takes place between DRDO and industries directly. We interact with Thales, we interact with SEGEN, we interact with MBDA and many other aerospace companies in Paris. We have identified in this collaboration today about 30 projects in different disciplines. They are in radars, they are in missiles, they are in sensors, they are in small weapons, they are in directed energy weapons, and even naval systems and things like that. So there are about 30 projects identified, and discussions are on the promulgation or execution of these programs in the near future. It's a very positive environment. Ecosystem is very supportive, and I must say that France has been a very good partner with India, even in the most difficult times.
And you mentioned that you are working on 30 projects. So what are the specific areas?
I mentioned to you, the missiles, there are projects on missiles, there are projects on sensors, navigation sensors, homing sensors, naval sensors. Then we are working on special project on air independent propulsion for the submarines as part of our AIP program. Then we have got some program on what is called decision support system. Then radars, we are trying to work on a shipborne radar, a radar which will operate from the ship. And we are also working on electronic warfare systems. So it's a fairly long list. And in each discipline, there may be sub-projects. It's not just, I'm talking of disciplines right now, but each project will have a definite definition, and there will be definite output identified. But one point I would like to mention, the relationship between DRDO and the R&D institutions and the companies in France is not one of buyer alone. It's more with respect to joint development, collaborative work. I'll give you an example that when we started this ballistic missile defense collaboration, we developed many elements of that radar in India and integrated with the work which was being done at Paris. So it's a joint work, and same has been planned for the SRSEM, in which we will be working on certain systems. The entire development will be done here, part of the development will be done in France, then the production will take place in our country. So these are models, these are the business models in which development and production are planned in its totality right in the beginning. Upfront we do that. And that's how our relationship is going.
Okay, so can we expect to see programs like BrahMos?
We have not yet planned any joint venture. See, BrahMos is a joint venture program between India and Russia. As on today, there is no joint venture program between India and Russia, India and France. You will appreciate the only relationship which has existed for the last 60 years is between Thales and our Bharat Electronics. Bharat Electronics and Thales started working together from 1953. And that relationship has produced many electronics equipments for our armed forces, which includes radars, communication systems, electronic warfare systems, and so on. So these facilities are, these projects are already going on. But even there, it is not a joint venture situation. It is basically working together, giving projects under license and so on. It is of that type.
So can we expect them?
We are open. In fact, I have today suggested to Thales, when are you going to have Thales India? You can tie up with either DRDO or any of my public sector or private industries and set up a joint venture company, which will do work on all the identified areas what we have talked of. These identified areas could be in missiles, it could be in ships, it could be in submarines, it could be in torpedoes, it could be in radars, computers, network-centric warfare, many things they could be. But there should be a R&D center which is run under joint venture program. Then there is a possibility. The only hitch I find which is coming there is the percentage of investment they would like to bring. What probably all companies outside India are thinking is that 26% FDI which is available today is not so adequate. If we are in a position to increase it to something like 49 or 50%, then I expect that the participation of the foreign companies, including those from France, in Indian R&D and production network would be higher. And that's a decision on our part. But the ecosystem to work on specific programs, create a special purpose vehicle or a special business unit is still open. Because when you do SVP or you do a special business unit, these limitations may not come.
Okay. And what kind of relations you have with other overseas market besides Paris, France?
As on today, our joint venture is only with Russia. That is the BrahMos. We don't have any other joint venture with any company today. Yes. We have R&D collaboration with, for example, Israel. We have R&D collaboration with UK. We have R&D collaboration with Russia. We also have with, now we initiated some discussions even with Germany. So we have many countries with whom the projects are done. And but the number of projects which we have identified for France are highest. That much I can tell you. Other the projects are not so high. Probably I can say after Russia, the next country with whom the numbers which we have identified is France. But we are always open to collaboration in R&D with many countries. It's a question of we should be able to identify mutually beneficial systems which should benefit your country, which should benefit my country, and which should benefit us. And it should be on a equal basis. It cannot be on a non-partisan, it cannot be on an unequal basis.
Okay. Moving on to Indian operations, if we talk about LCA helicopter, so what is the status of ongoing projects?
See, even in the all these programs like LCA, today LCA is under advanced stage of development. Its initial operation clearance is over. Phase 1 is over, now phase 2 will take place this year sometime in September or October. Then final operation clearance. But notwithstanding this, the production activity at HAL has already started. first two aircraft should be ready by end of this year. The induction program with the Indian Air Force is also on. They are creating the infrastructure for inducting the equipment in their Air Force. So all these activities are in parallel. Now there is a scope for any country to even participate today, because we are looking at augmenting the production capability of HAL for producing LCA. That means we are looking for technologies, manufacturing technologies, which can increase the production rate and the quality of production. So we have actually done a lot of survey in which France was one of the countries. We have visited Germany, France, and there are talks on for how to bring in foreign countries to carry out this task. Of course, HAL is capable of doing all by themselves, but to reduce time and to be first time right, it is better to collaborate.
Okay, so are you looking for any in the IT sector or something?
IT sector, see, as far as defense is concerned, we are not in the IT in a generic sense. Our IT is very specific. For example, we are looking at systems which are embedded systems. We are looking at cyber security, systems for cyber security. Such systems, out of those 30 projects which I mentioned, in Paris we have identified cyber security products, both software and hardware, as one of the areas. So IT, generic IT, no. We are not talking of BPOs and call centers. We have no such mandate also. DRDO does not do in this. But we do application software, we do specific expert systems, artificial intelligence. These are the areas in which we invite participation. And they are specific to either network-centric operations, they could be specific to autonomous operation of the systems, or they could be specific to development of various simulation and modeling software for design and development. They are in that class. So IT we will exploit only in this format, not in the format in which generic people are using today. IT is used in a very loose way, what Infosys is doing or what Wipro is doing. No, not that type of IT. DRDO doesn't. But we have a program to build our systems which are completely free of all kinds of viruses. So we will invite people to participate in India's own operating system development. For example, development of Indian operating system. You understand operating system. We are looking at hardware which is specific to India, like Indian servers, Indian switches, Indian routers, Indian backplane electronics and all that. So this is another area in which we have identified working with Paris and many other countries.
Okay. And what are the other projects or weapons which you launched on the market and they are under development?
Today DRDO in its portfolio has many programs. For example, besides LCA, we have embarked on the development of advanced medium combat aircraft, which is at the design stage today. We are also working on UAVs. We have got medium altitude male UAV, medium endurance and altitude UAV, long endurance. So this kind of UAV work is going on. Then we are also working on various missiles. We are developing an anti-radiation missile. We are also developing some long-range surface-to-air missiles. We are also working the next generation of anti-tank missiles. We are working on a beyond visual range tactical missile which can be integrated on our Sukhoi, it can be integrated on LCA tomorrow and so on. We have embarked on a program on synthetic aperture radar development. You are aware of our program on airborne early warning and control system, AVAC, which is in the advanced stage of development. The next version of that AVAC will be Indian AVAC, which will have, which is almost like Falcon, which is what the Indian Air Force has taken, but on a different aircraft, on a different configuration than the present Falcon, which will be completely phased array radar technology with 360 degree coverage, with a long endurance and things like that. So these are some of the programs which are already in the, what I would say, design stage. They are all in the design stage. These programs are going to take place. I'm not talking of those which are like LCA or Agni or those are, they are already on. I'm talking of those which are taking off.
And during Aero 2013, you mentioned that Agni 6 is likely to be come. So what is the status right now?
I have mentioned during the Aero 2013 in Bangalore that we have a derivative of Agni 5 which will be fitted with MIRVs. That development activity has been initiated and we are not calling it Agni 6, by the way, it is not Agni 6. So it will be derivative, name will be maybe Agni 5 plus or whatever that. But its functionality will be to increase, to provide force multiplication by putting MIRVs as part of the system. So that is what we are planning to do as far as Agni 5 is concerned. Besides, of course, carrying out more flight trials of Agni 5 in its present configuration, canisterizing it and making it more and more mobile, so that it can be launched from the mobile launchers.
And some projects have undergone time overrun and huge cost. So why does this happen and
how? You want to talk on the Paris Air Show this?
No, but it's the part of projects. So.
Yeah, but you want to talk, I have no problem. No. See, every development activity is a press, is a very complex process. Mm-hmm. Our development activities are done under three or four different conditions. Condition one is, if you take projects which started in 1980s and they are running even today, for example LCA, it started in 83-84 and we are doing now, so 20-25 years. Or you take many of the missile programs which started in 80s, many of them completed. These projects, when they started in 80s, they started with a limited industrial infrastructure, limited technology capability, and our dependence for completing this project was also on import of certain systems, subsystems, components. But unfortunately, as soon as we developed Agni 1, the Agni and the Prithvi, we were subjected to missile technology control regimes. MTCR closed the window of availability of systems from Europe and America, including France. That resulted in Indian R&D engine to take on the development of such systems which were supposed to have been purchased. LCA suffered a major setback because LCA was planned in close collaboration with American industry, Martin Marietta, Lockheed Martin. All these companies were supposed to provide many subsystems and support to LCA program. As soon as 1988-89 happened, just within about 8 years of the program, not even 8 years, 5 years, 6 years of the program, there was a total clamp. My control system activity which was going on in, I think Martin Marietta, was completely closed. So LCA had to do its complete development without the support of those countries, those industries which were supposed to have been done. In India, we did not have those capabilities. So we have to now build those capabilities and then build LCA. Obviously, it takes time. Yeah. No? Is it not? Yeah. Now you go and buy this button in your shirt. Directly you go and buy in the market. Now suppose the button is not made available for your shirt. And you say button is not. Now you have to set up a button factory first before you can stitch your kurta. That is a typical situation which our country faced. We converted into an opportunity. Opportunity this way, that whatever shortages were there, whatever gaps were there, those technologies we developed ourselves. While it took time, while it took money, but we became self-sufficient in those technologies. Today India can manufacture any electromechanical actuator. We can manufacture servo valves, we can manufacture radar components, we can manufacture materials like titanium and maraging steel and different types of aluminum which were supposed to have been imported for all these systems. Today we are making TR modules for our radars which were supposed to have been. All this was feasible because of a very focused program which was initiated after 89 when this MTCR came in. Between 89 and 2001 or 2002, we licked up all this. But its impact was the main program suffered because these things were not available. This was the main reason for time overrun and cost overrun, because we had not planned to put the cost of development of these items as part of our project planning. We had, if I make this cell phone, I buy for 20,000 rupees. But if I set up a factory for making the cell phone, it may take maybe 10 crores to set up a factory or 20 crores to set up a factory. So that kind of cost overrun comes. That resulted in time and cost overrun. So besides that, many factors which are related to, of course, our user, because he would like to get modifications in the GSQR. So he would like to change certain systems. This is one another reason for delays. So controls, user, industry not able to take on high-tech jobs because our industrial infrastructure was not so advanced. This is very much corroborated by what has been done in 2005 onwards. All projects which DRDO has taken from 2005 onwards, by and large, the time and cost overrun has been reduced. I won't say zero, but it has been reduced considerably. Now, no project is going for 15 years, 20 years. Reason, industrial infrastructure in the country has gone up. Technology level has gone up. Academic institutions are today able to participate in our programs and projects. DRDO and other departments of science and technology have also upped their technology to a very large extent. As a result, today we can complete the platform development, system development, subsystem development at a faster pace. Agni 5 was done only in 3.5 years. Such a major system, whereas the first Agni took about 12 years. So you can see the difference yourself. And first Agni and Agni 5, there's no comparison. Agni 5 is a much, much bigger system, much more complex, whereas Agni 1 or what we had done was a simpler system. But some technologies like re-entry technologies and all that we could do even with those controls. Okay? That explains your time and cost over.
Yeah. And can we say talent is also an issue for this?
Yes, human resource is very important. And we had the impact of the non-availability of good resource, human resource, due to this IT revolution which took place in the country. Particularly from middle of 90s, something like 92, 93 onwards, when the major IT industries started coming in the country, with I would say remuneration packages which were far too high compared to what the engineering industry was providing, or academic institutions were providing, or R&D institutions were providing. This resulted in exodus, because people moved away from the government institutions to private IT institutions, where even a newcomer or just a college pass out was getting 30,000, 40,000 rupees, and now probably turns into 1 lakh rupees. So that was the situation. So exodus took place. Second thing is, our main intellectual resource which was available from IITs, IISCs and good engineering colleges, even those boys and girls started joining that IIT because of these industries. Because of this, they are coming into R&D also suffered. But this situation has changed now. It is no more that situation. Today, we are in a position to attract, because of the 6-pay commission, because of the improvement in the pay packages which the government is providing today. And more than that, people have also realized that if you are looking for technology challenges, it is only in 3 or 4 strategic departments that you have: Department of Defense Research, Department of Space, and Department of Atomic Energy. So as a result, they do not, they have started coming away from IT. A good boys and girls are now coming to DRDO, DOE and DAS, mainly because challenge lies here. And reasonably good pay package is also there. Second thing is, they realized that IT, there is no challenge. Repetitive work, monotonous work, without any application of your brain. Yes, you become affluent within about 5 years. You have all the basic high-end amenities available. But then you are a youngster at the age of 30, 35, what do you do? There is no food for your intellectual capabilities. And as a result, people have realized, so good students are coming. Last year I had about 100 IIT graduates joining us. This year we have already taken 110, they are undergoing training. So I am seeing the shift. Second thing is, DRDO also has provided now very challenging technological programs. When people talk about Agni-5 or AEW&C or AVAC or MBT Arjun or any of these things, they get excited, they get challenges coming in. So both these factors put together, I think human resource availability has improved. But I can only say that the quantum of programs and projects which we have taken today, which is so large, it is at least 10 to 15 times more than what existed in 80s and 90s. Today, my total program values are exceeding 80,000 crores. Whereas in 80s and 90s, I didn't have programs even 4,000, 5,000 crores. So when I'm going to such level of and the size of the program, obviously you need more human resource. Now, that means our academic institutions should be in a position to produce employable graduates, postgraduates, doctorates, employable, mind my word, employable, who can fit in the type of tasks and challenges which we are offering. Now, that's a big mismatch existing today. While there are a large number of private institutions coming up in engineering field, but there's a question mark with respect to the quality of the engineers which are coming. There's a question mark with respect to their employability. So as a result, the human resource availability for India's programs still remains a major issue. And something has to be done about it. The only way what we are doing is, we are taking the normal engineers also, besides the engineers coming from IITs and all that, and then putting them through an induction program, training them in our institute at Defense Institute of Armament Technology, and then making them join our institution. So there is a kind of induction training program, kind of coaching and teaching, and making them do research work. That is going on to bring them at par with the best what we are having today. But it's a very painstaking process. It is expected to be done by our educational institutions. And that is one factor which is to be looked at globally in the country.
Okay. And talking about budget, so what are your current budgets look like?
We are in the region of about 10,000 crores. 10,000 crores is what, 2 billion? About 2 billion. Mm-hmm. And we need more. That's all I can say. As far as my programs are concerned, we need more money.
Okay, so are you happy?
Were you there in the awards function today?
Yes.
You must have read, heard me talking in the speech also. I said we need more human resource, we need more money for taking on the challenging task what we are talking of.
So it is appropriate to create world-class military technologies, this budget?
See, we are spending something like about 5% of our defense budget. But if you compare today this with what the other countries are doing, we are nowhere compared. China is doing 20%. Yeah. America is also in the same region, 15 to 25% in that region, whereas we are 5%. So obviously it is subcritical. And we want to match the technological competence of all the developed nations. So obviously, the desire has to match with the action, and action is in terms of investment. Desire is to be at par, but your actions are not at par. No?
Yeah. And finally, at the air show, what would you like to see exactly? DRDO?
I'm sending a team which is going to visit the Paris Air Show. Paris Air Show is one of the better air shows compared to other venues which I have been to. I have been to Paris Air Shows twice. I find the participation is of a higher order, number one. There are technologies which are new technologies always showcased there. This is what I have seen. And the French industry participation is very high. And the European industry comes in a big way. So we expect that out of those 30-40 projects and programs that we are highlighting, we would be looking for some kind of tie-ups with many of the industries to suit the requirements of our projects. whether it is the naval projects like torpedoes, or it is communication projects, or the aircraft projects, or the missile projects. We will be looking for components, we will be looking for sensors, we will be looking for even software packages which will help us to do better design, simulation and modeling systems. And also we want to look at the emerging scenario of ballistic missile defense. A very, very critical aspect is the decision support system. There are agencies in France which are working on the state-of-the-art decision support system for BMD, battle management systems. So this will be our basic theme when we go and look at the Paris Air Show. Maybe radars which are fitted on the aircraft, phased array radar, gallium nitride-based technology, we are looking at how to get TR modules which are working on gallium nitride. So our plate is full. We want to capture as much as we can.
Thank you so much. Very well done, sir.
Thank you.
So these are some of our magazines for your reading pleasure. This is our latest issue dedicated to the OECD summit.
Very nice. Vaidya, doing a good job.
Thank you so much, sir. This is our Pravasi Bhartiya Divas special issue.
Is Pravasi Bhartiya Divas any impact it is making? No. Is Pravasi Bhartiya make any impact? I don't agree to that.
This is our 2000.
Pravasi Bhartiya. Shri Kardiya.